Hi, in today's video, I would like to talk about the importance of Guru in one's life. Before we go into the importance of Guru, let's look at the meaning of the word Guru according to Sanskrit. Gu means spiritual ignorance and Ru means spiritual knowledge. So when you have a Guru in your life, your spiritual ignorance will go away and you will have spiritual knowledge. It is important that every human being has got a Guru in his life to guide him in the right path. Without Guru, your life would become astray. Some people are destined to have a Guru in their life and others not. We don't know if we are destined to meet our Guru in this life. If we are destined, we are lucky. But I think it is everyone's responsibility to find out who their Guru is. Having a teacher or guide in any field is invaluable. If we want to learn a certain art, we approach a master who has got knowledge about that. If we want to learn car driving, for example, we approach a driving school. So who will groom us on the spiritual front? Is there anybody who can guide us in this spiritual life, which is intangible and subtle? It can only be experienced. You cannot prove one spirituality level under laboratory conditions. Hence, it becomes very difficult to find someone, to find a guru who can help them in their spiritual path. By scientific or rational means, you will have to go with your own intuition. You will have to pray to the universal life force to give you the right guru. Do you agree with me that the reason for all the world problems is because of ego, lust, search for money, and our human mind, which is not happy with whatever we get in life? The more we get, the more poor we are. The more rich we become, the more poor we are. There is no end to this constant search of material pleasures in this world. There has to be a point where this has to stop. And one should understand the real meaning of life. One should understand that this life is an illusion. When we were young, we had so many thoughts in our mind about our life. But when we become a bit old, when we are in our adolescence, we see that all those thoughts, whatever we had in our mind, was childish. It never happened, or it was probably foolish to think of those things. Similarly, whatever we do now might become foolish at one point of time. Now, I'm not saying that everybody should leave their family, wife and children and get into spirituality. That's not the point that I'm trying to make. The point that I'm trying to prove here is that one needs to have a spiritual master to guide him in his life. And when you have a spiritual master or a guru, your life becomes much better than how it was earlier. Now, how do I go and search for a guru? How do I know that which guru is a right guru for me? There are thousands of gurus out there who come in Ferraris, who have their own palace, and then they advise others not to follow materialism. I'm not getting into that part right now. And I'm not saying that a saint is someone who just needs to bless everybody, lead a life, a very simple life. Yes, that is the traditional concept of a guru, but life has changed, times have changed, and there are gurus of all kinds today. So as I had mentioned earlier, it's important that everybody has got a spiritual guru in his life. What if I ask you to go and learn science without a teacher? How will you get the knowledge, or how will you have access to knowledge through research that has been done for hundreds of years? So you need to have an access, you need to have a teacher to learn something. Similarly, in your spiritual life, you need to have a guru who can guide you. A lot of people are under the assumption that the guru needs to live in human body to guide their disciple, which is not the case. If you have a guru who is living right now, you can go to him, you can clarify your doubts. But there are gurus, there are saints who can guide you in invisible form. Most of the saints and most of the gurus in various cultures are living in astral form. They continue to guide humanity. They continue to help people during times of distress. They mold people's personality. They make sinners into people who have great personalities, who start helping people. So, it is a myth that you need to have a living guru. If you have a living guru, great. But that doesn't mean that you need to have a living guru if you want to improve in your spiritual life. You can have an invisible guru, a guru who has lived like 100, 200, 500 years back. Science talks about the gross aspect of this life. It talks about something that is physical, that can be found out through experiments. But there are so many things that is beyond the understanding of the five senses. Things that cannot be comprehended with human mind. You need to understand that our intellect and our understanding of this world is limited. Before 100 years, we never knew so many things that we have in today's life. Science has given us great things. I'm not against science, I'm a supporter of science, but at the same time, there are so many things that cannot be experienced through an apparatus, through a telescope, or something that can be explained through scientific means. And these are experiences of the soul. When you come in contact with a divine being, you will understand what is real peace, what is happiness, what is the purpose of this life, what am I doing right now. You will know that this life is temporary. It's full of illusion. When the disciple is ready, the guru appears. Not everyone will get a guru from the time they were born. You can meet your guru at the age of 30, at the age of 50, or maybe even at the age of 5 or 8. There have been several spiritual masters in India who met their gurus when they were young. And so, they had a transformation in their life. We all understand how important a guru is for a disciple right now. And we also know the importance of having a guru. What kind of changes it can make in your life? When a guru comes into your life, you can see that you will walk on the path of truth. You will not have hatred, but you will have love for others. You will not get angry. You will become a very calm, sensible person. You will forgive others. You will be submissive. Now there is a difference between being aggressive and being angry or going to any extent to satisfy your selfish desires. So when you have a guru, you become much more matured. Even parents cannot teach you what a guru teaches you, because the guru doesn't give you lectures. A guru is someone who guides you through your consciousness. It's very difficult to explain by scientific means how someone can work through your consciousness, but it is true, guys. A guru can help you in so many ways. He can inject the right thought into your mind at the right time. He will warn you when you are going wrong. You will always Feel that there is somebody behind you who is guiding you in your life. Now, let me tell you how you can find your guru. First of all, if you want to find your guru, you need to have a genuine interest to walk on the spiritual path. Sometimes a guru comes into your life all of a sudden and everything changes. This can happen when you visit an ashram, a tomb, a church. Mantras have profound effects on the mind. The mantras are sounds that travels into the universe and connects us with the right consciousness. Mantras, if chanted continuously, can make the sound waves into light waves. It can create a particular form, a particular image of the person whom you are trying to call. You would have seen in most of the horror films that somebody sits in an old mansion or an old house and then he tries to invoke spirits. The Ouija board. You have the board and then you chant the name of the spirit and then it comes. Similarly, you can attract invisible beings into your life and you can feel the change. It all depends on what you want to attract in your life. Once you've decided what you want to attract in your life, then you need to think about how you can attract it. You need to find out the ways. There are mantras that are very powerful that can bring instant blessings of a guru to you. You can go and meditate where saints are present, either in a physical form or in a non-physical form. They continue to be there as unseen masters. So guys, instead of trying to live in a world of ignorance, instead of trying to prove everything through the lens of science, I would suggest everybody to go and find your spiritual master. I wish that everybody who is watching this video gets their spiritual master soon. Thank you.